What's going on, everybody? It's Frito here for Clickheads. Spike Rush is the brand new game mode to Valorant. Today, we're going to break it down and give it our review. Spike Rush essentially is a simplified version of a normal unrated or rated match of Valorant, with everything shorter, more straightforward, and a bit more wacky. Instead of having to worry about the economy system or buying your weapons, each round that's determined for you, you come stocked with all of your abilities. Then as you proceed through the max 7 rounds, you'll go from playing pistols to anti-eco to full buy. The guns are pre-selected for you and have a bit of RNG to them, and everyone gets the same weapon. That'll be a bit of a positive and a negative we'll discuss later. And to alleviate the normal tactics that are required for teams to work together, every attacking player has a spike they can plant, and there are power-up orbs scattered across the map that kind of remind of Quake power-ups. You can get hyper speed to move really fast, an instant ultimate, an upgraded weapon, which can be very significant if the entire lobby is on shorties and you can pick up a Vandal, or a kind of complicated crippling decay ability that, when activated, will reduce the enemy's health down to 10, sort of like if Viper's decay mechanic was super OP, meaning that for that duration, you can rush the enemy down and shoot them in the toe and confirm a kill. All of these things contributes to the game to play a lot scrimmier, a lot faster, and a lot wackier than a normal match of Valorant. Now, the intention of this mode, according to Riot, is to blow off steam after a rough match or in between matches. And in one regard, it definitely is a success in that it is a very short game mode that you don't care if you win or lose. But my counter argument to that would be, does anybody really feel too attached to winning and losing in unrated anyway? Yes, the duration is shorter, but one thing that I wasn't a huge fan of is there not being any interesting ways to determine the weapon you're going to be using on the given round. You will be able to adjust your playstyle and angles you take based on the mirrored weapon across everyone, and things do get more interesting when you start to combine teamwork to try to fight over the power-up orbs. But to me anyway, one of the most interesting things about Valorant is the economy system and the asymmetrical matchups you can get. When everybody's got shorties, it just sort of becomes a cluster, in my opinion. I'd almost rather that there was more ways to pick up weapons and we somehow retained like a quick buy system that allowed us to mostly play the weapons we all love to play and left the corny ones off to the side a little bit, so there wasn't as many straight up goofy rounds. I believe Riot has heard the criticisms of players wanting a mode to warm up their mechanics, like deathmatch. Due to the unreliability of what gun you're going to be using round to round, I wouldn't say that this fulfills that need, and this may be the former Quake player in me that states this, but I kind of wish the power-ups were a little more impactful than they already feel. They change where they spawn based on the rounds, and you won't know which ones are going to spawn in, so it's a bit of a coin flip who gets the lucky draw on which power-up they lean towards. Then it randomly spawns as one of the multiple options. Depending on the RNG gun you get, the RNG power-up that spawns in front of you can get increased or decreased value, which I suppose is kind of interesting. For example, decaying everyone's health down to 10 matters a lot more when everyone's got a spammable weapon than it does when everyone has an operator. But due to the unreliability of them, I mostly felt like I should be playing the round normally and bait the orbs like you typically do anyway, and only really get them if you're fully safe. And in that way, I feel this mode is kind of holding back. One huge positive that this mode brings to the table is the attacking side gets a massive buff in this because there's 5 bombs, so anybody can plant at any time. But also, the way the map design is, typically orbs are pretty accessible to the attacking team, especially on a map like Split that's been routinely balanced away from allowing the defenders to have free mid control, and there's 2 orbs in mid, meaning that you're very likely to get some of these power-ups, but like I've said before, it's RNG whether that matters to you or not. I don't mean to try to discuss this mode more seriously than it needs to be, but I sort of want to see it go the other way and not lose some of the most fun aspects of Valorant, and instead apply to casual players that may otherwise not get into the game at all. I don't feel this gameplay is such a big divergence from a normal unrated match, and I think that's a missed opportunity. It both isn't focused enough to be useful to a hardcore player that's looking to work on their mechanics, and it isn't crazy enough to really feel like like pure fun. In my opinion anyway, if they're gonna make a casual mode, why not amp up how much it can appeal to that style of player? Because I don't think a hardcore player is ever gonna play this anyway. So why can't I get a power-up that gives me infinite hot hands as Phoenix, for example, or whatever, right? The rounds and the games are short anyway, so I'd like to see the gameplay stretched a bit to be more different than standard Valorant so we can get more players interested in the game overall. But I wasn't looking for mystery guns in Valorant personally anyway. I did want an awesome casual mode, but at this point, I'd be more excited to see a gun game or a normal deathmatch mode rather than Spike Rush. And that's about it for today. Let me know your thoughts on the Spike Rush game mode. Were you as underwhelmed as I was? And what potential do you see in the mode? Put your suggestions in the comment section down below. You never know. Riot devs sometimes do watch our videos. They might end up seeing it and implement it into the game. If you enjoyed the video, please be sure to leave it a like. It really does help us out. Let us know that you're enjoying the content. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe and be sure to hit the bell icon to actually get notified when our videos go live. You can check out our Facebook stream. We'll be streaming a lot of Valorant this week, linked in the description. Otherwise, that's been it for me. I've been Frito for Clickheads. We'll see you guys next time.